been a minute.
What was the thought process behind that?
Just ready for a change. I don't know, I had it for 7 years, so just ready for a change.
It wasn't the Louisiana heat, was it? You used to it in Texas, I guess.
No, it wasn't the heat, even though it's different in Texas, but no, it wasn't the heat.
It looks like you slimmed down a little bit. Is that true, or is that just my imagination?
No, I definitely lost a few pounds, leaned up, and off season just working on, you know, be able to move a little bit better. So, yeah, I lost a little weight.
Was that a plan? Was that a goal, or did it just
kind of
happen naturally?
It was a goal. I was came in big, and it was still kind of chubby last year, and wanted to lean down a little bit more. So, yeah, it was a goal to lose some weight.
Does that help with speed, flexibility, both?
It helps with a lot, the speed, flexibility, being able to change directions. It helps with everything, honestly.
Do you feel that paying off in camp, just the way you've been able to go?
I feel like it has. I feel like I've had one of my better camps since the 3 years I've been here, so, yeah.
What did those first 2 years teach you just about being in the NFL, just whether it was being kind of up and down at times or even being on the field? What was kind of the biggest moment,
Just, I need to work on my craft a little bit more. I think that was the biggest thing. I just need to learn how to work and actually be a pro. And being around guys in those locker room helped out a lot.
What do you mean by that? Like route running, like technical stuff?
Like or? Just technical stuff. Yeah. Like being detailed as a receiver. Taking care of your body. Just all the little small things that go into it that people don't really think about.
Yeah.
You were coming out of camp last year. Do you feel like you had done enough to make the 53-man roster?
Last year I felt like. I feel like I had a chance to, but, you know, I didn't. And I knew I had an opportunity to be on practice squad, develop some more, and possibly get play, and I end up playing. So, I mean, I feel like I had a chance to, but I wasn't really worried about it because I got an opportunity to develop a lot more and get better.
So it's just one of those things where you, like, swallow your disappointment for, like, an hour, and then because things happen so fast, like, by the next day you're already kind of
moving on to... Yeah. I mean, like, it hurt, again, you know, having to come in and get cut and go on the practice squad, but you just got to swallow it. It was like, okay, like, I'm getting that chance to get better. And it obviously believed in me, so I was happy about that and just came to work every day.
Do you think not having any preseason games last year played into that? And how excited are you that, you have preseason games against
it? I mean, I don't know if the games played into that or not, but, like, I'm happy. Like, I get to showcase some skills. This Saturday, and hopefully, I do a good job and do my job.
Hey, Lil Jordan, what do you think about the start to camp Quez has had? It seems like he's just like got a lot of belief in himself right now.
Quez been killing it out there. I mean, he's believing in him, and coach, we believe in him. He's just been going out there balling, being himself, honestly, and he's showing that.
Yeah, like he legit looks like somebody who like kind of believes he's like. The number one receiver.
I mean, yeah, like, I don't think it's a guy in there who don't believe it with him, you know what I mean? So, like, he just got the confidence, and he just keep going and getting better every day, so, yeah.
What's it been like sort of just watching Jameis and Taysom and how they're kind of different, I guess, as far as their styles of leadership?
I mean, Taysom is kind of like the guy who's going to really come up to you, you know, talk to you. Jameis is a little bit more, vocal, but I mean, it's not really a big difference. They both are great leaders, you know what I mean? So it's just being out there and getting connection with them, and so communicating with them, so we can be on the right page. So like I said, they're both great leaders. So,
what do you think about Texas trying to become a member of the SEC?
I think it's cool. We got a lot of rivalries going back. That's gonna come back, like game against Arkansas. Game gives A&M, so I mean, I think it's gonna be exciting. It's gonna help us out a lot with recruiting.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.